Hi everyone, welcome you all. In our previous videos, we have seen how to perform mouse over and how to perform right click and then double click actions. Now, today I'm going to show you how can we perform drag and drop operation in Playwright. So to demonstrate this, I'm taking this website and which contains a drag and drop feature. You can just go back here. And here you can see this is a different capitals are listed out here and then countries. So we need to drag particular capital into country. So you can just drag and drop whatever you want. You can say Rome into Italy like this and Washington into United States like this. You can just drag and drop. Okay. So how can we achieve this in Playwright? So there are two methods are there. So two approaches which we have and we can drag and drop. So I will show you both the approaches. So first of all, I'll launch this application first. Go back and go to VS Code Editor. And I already created one spec file, drag-and-drop.spec.js under my test folder. And already imported test and expert functions from Playwright test module. And then I created one test function. So inside this, I'm going to write a code. So await page.goto. And this will open our application. And then, so first of all, before performing drag and drop, we need to know source element and target element. So if we know source and target element, we can easily perform the drag and drop. Suppose here my source element is, let's say, Rome and my target element is Italy. So I can say inspect this Rome element first. And if I look at here for this element, you can see the ID is also available. You can just import this, inspect this element. Okay, let me just refresh once again. Yeah. So let's inspect this element, Rome. And when inspecting this element, this is the element and there is ID called box 6. Okay, so for every element, there is an ID. So I'm just directly taking this box 6 is an ID and go back and get that element. Await page.locator. And here, this is the element. This is the ID. So I'm just using hash because this is a CSS. Hash ID. And this will get that element. And this is my source element. Okay, so I can just put in const variable. This is Italy. All right, this is Rome. Okay, this is a source element. Now, similarly, we need to capture the target element. So to capture the target element, again, let's try to inspect the target element is Italy. And the ID of this Italy is box 106. Now, again, you can go back. And here, get that element also. Await page.locator. And specify the ID of this element. Now this will give you target element. I'm just storing into const variables, const Italy. Okay, now I captured the source element and this is my target element. So once you know source and target elements, we can easily perform the drag and drop. Now in the first approach, there is a direct method available, drag and drop method is available, but if I don't use drag and drop method, we can use in another way. I can show you approach one. So to perform the drag and drop, first what we need to do, we need to mouse over on the first element, source element, and click. Okay, we need to first mouse over on the Rome, and we need to perform the click action, and then mouse over on Italy, and then release the mouse action. So here we need to do mouse over along with mouse down and mouse up. So on the Rome element, we need to place the mouse over, and then mouse down, and after that, we need to go to Italy element, where we need to again mouse over and mouse up. So two multiple actions we have to do. So that's the first approach. So first thing is we need to await on the Rome element. I want to perform the hover action I will do. This is a mouse over action. And also we need to perform the mouse down, mouse click. So for that we need to use one more method, Rome.hover and here page.mouse.down. So this is the method we have to call. Mouse dot down. So Rome dot hover. Once we put the mouse over on this element, then we have to call this method page dot mouse dot down. After that, we need to go to target element await Italy dot and hover. So here we need to mouse over on the Italy and then await mouse dot up. So here we need to release the mouse. So basically, we are clicking down on the mouse and here we are making up. So first we need to mouse over on the Rome element, mouse down, and then mouse over on target element, then mouse up. So these four actions will perform the drag and drop. So this is the first approach. Indirectly, we can use mouse over along with the mouse down and mouse up. So now save the file and then go and execute it. So after that, I'm just keeping some wait statement so that we can clearly see whether it is drag and drop or not. Await page dot wait for timeout, and I can specify 5000 milliseconds. Okay. Now save the file and then go back and execute. So the command is npx playwright test and test. And the file name is this one. So we need to change the file name. So the file name is what? Mouse drag and drop. Or there is no mouse, only drag and drop. Drag and drop. Drag and drop dot spec dot js. Now execute. Now just observe. Yes, now you can see the Rome is got dragged into Italy. So successfully done. So this is the one option which is having. By using hover method, we can do it. The combination of hover and mouse down and mouse up. So apart from this, instead of using four statements, you can simply have one single statement, we can do it. So let me show you another approach. You can say approach two. So direct method, what I can do is await. What is the source element here? Rome is my source element. So take that element, row dot, there is a method called drag to, and then specify the target element. So what is the target element here is Italy is my target element. So that you can specify. Simple, one single statement. So go to the row source element dot target, drag to target element. So this will perform the drag and drop operation. Now save the file and go and execute one more time. Yes, now it is performed the drag and drop. Okay, move to Italy. So this is single step we can do. Okay, similarly, let me try another options, another element. Suppose I want to move this Washington into United States. Now we need to capture the source and target elements. Now let's capture the Washington element. The ID is box 3. Okay, now we can just go back and now get that element. So Washington to US. Okay. So await page dot locator. And this is my ID. This is a Washington, right? Washington element. So I'm that going to store in a variable Washington equal to. And I can make this as a const variable. And this is a source element. Now, what is the target element here? Is the target element United States. Now inspect this target element, and the ID of this element is box 103. Now get that element also, const USA equal to await page dot locator and specify the ID. So whatever locator you have, we can use it. So now I got the source element and target element. Simply we can perform the drag and drop in with single statement. I can say await. What is the source element is? Washington is my source element. And a dot command is drag to of target element, which is USA. Okay, so in the first approach, I have moved Rome into Italy, drag and drop. And the second example, I moved Washington into USA. Okay, and save a single statement, source element dot drag to target element. Okay, now execute the test. Yes, now we can see both have moved Rome into Italy and Washington into United States. Okay, so this is how we can simply do drag and drop in Playwright. So by writing the multiple commands using hover and mouse dot down, mouse dot up, there's one approach. Second approach is very simple, straightforward. By using drag to method, we can do it. Source element dot drag to and then target element. Simply, we can do the drag and drop operation in Playwright. Okay. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. We'll see in the next video.